Hello， 大家好 ，Welcome to Call the Gallery。It's very nice to see you again. Now I have already arrived to my home, but I'm still isolated in for coronavirus. So for this week, I'm going to show you in China, it's very difficult to work. To be a boyfriend in China. And you know, for some issues, like for example, the Chinese girl they need to require a car, a house, or apartment when they want to get married with. I want to marry with you. Yeah. So, also, when you get married, they also have a lot of requirement. That is only for some girls, but maybe I need a bit exaggerate that. But it's for some situation, for some for this phenomenon. So I want just to use the cartoon or use the GIF cartoon to show that. The first one is called 在天朝男人要养家还要回家要洗碗 is when you need to do some homework, housework for the husband. You need to give the money, to give all the money, all your salary to your wife. And afterwards, you also need to do the housework. Yeah. For some men, men in China, they indeed do like this. Yes. But they are very good. They are very kind person. The second one is called 在天朝年终奖就要全部上交。Yeah, that's also true. When you get all the salary, you need to give all your salary to your wife, and your wife will control everything. Yeah, for some men, and they have some reasons. They want to control the money so they can control the man, so the man cannot go outside to, for example, go to the red zone, Latin zone, red Latin zone, 红灯区, or they can't treat some males with some beautiful girl. Yeah, so I think that's the reason. But for the man, it's a little bit pity. And afterwards, I'm going to enjoy a lot some serious story beyond this situation. And not only in these two examples, also I'm going to draw more. OK, 所以话说到这边，大家也就知道为什么在隔离期间之后，就是隔离之后有这么多人，他们有这么高的离婚率，就连我们这边小小的惠州，他也都会有很多人离婚的情况。因为就是像我之前所说的， 一个结婚的一个在两个人之间最容易发生冲突的是那个地方是在厨房，因为厨房的话特别是做饭，有的你知道女生她会控制欲特别强，她就什么东西她都要插手，然后你就嫌你洗碗洗的不干净啊，或者你做菜里面可能这个菜没洗干净啊，所以她这会特别容易造成一个冲突，然后在这个冲突的情况下就会有很大的吵架，这些因素会发生，然后在于是在这样的情况下的话，我很多夫妻他们就会有一个很大的吵架，然后之后就会产生什么三观不合呀，人生观有问题呀，然后你的那个做事方式会有问题啊，因为他们之前从来都没做过饭，因为他们之前也不会说来隔离期一般都订个外卖，以前的话可能大家都出去吃大家都很和睦，从来没有去想过这些事情，然后真正的两个人处了之后发现这个做饭又是个问题，然后平常的时候可能两个人不在一起，有的男生可能会去我也不好说吧，就是做按摩吧，就是去大保健啊，这种 massage， 然后去完之后他们就可能就能把这些东西释放出来，然后结果在隔离期完全释放不出来，然后年终奖还得要上交，这些事情做饭洗碗做饭做家务，以前他们不愿意做的事情都要做，当然这些事情我是挺爱做的，不是自我表扬了，这一块的话主要是因为我觉得这是生活的一部分，这很有意思，因为我知道我周边有些特别工作上面特别有能力的人，他们一点家务都不会做，有我的老师，有我的教授，有我的领导都有，这块不是爆料他们的时候，反正就是每个人他对生活的态度是不一样的，所以在这一个漫画里面我会加上一些夸张的元素和周边的一些事物去综合到一起，希望大家可以喜欢。另外给大家一个幸运礼物，在隔离期的观众们粉丝们，如果你们喜欢我的作品的话大家可以在评论区做评论，然后我会随机给一个幸运的观众或者第一个幸运第一个给我留言的我会给他在手机壳或者包包上面去选一个，你可以用我的作品去定制一个手机壳或者定制一个包包，是免费的哦，而且机会只有一次。最后想说用我们老大说的，雾霾即将散去，光明始终会过来， Cloud will break。然后呢，我就像这个表情包一样就炸掉了。